Hello and welcome. In the last video, we had a discussion about UVM copy and UVM print method. Now in this video, I just walk you through another important built-in method, so-called compare method. Okay. Now see, in case of system Verilog, if you want to perform a comparison, we need to write our own comparison logic, our own compare method. While in case of UVM, there is no need to write our own compare method. Of our own logic, just call this compare method, inbuilt method. Okay, now see, first two lines are mandatory. Already I have written a code in order to save our time. These first two lines are mandatory. First one is import UVM package followed by scope resolution operator star. Okay, now this line will give us an access of UVM package, whereas this tick UVM tick include UVM macros.svh. This line will give us an access to UVM macros, all the macros we are using. Okay, now see, I have declared a very simple class, class transition extends from UVM sequence item. Okay, now in this class, I am declaring some properties and I am declaring them as a rand because I want them to randomize in future. Okay, now see, as it is object class in the UVM base class hierarchy, we need to do the factory registration by using tick UVM object it is. Okay, now see, this is what the field registration macros, and I am just writing that address write enable read enable, and I am writing UVM all on. I want all operation to be on, like copy, compare, print, all. If you do not want anything, if you don't want to do copy or compare or clone, you can write UVM no compare, no clone, no copy, something like this. Now this is what vertical bar UVM decimal. I want to print these properties in the decimal form. By default, it will print in hexadecimal form. Okay. Now see, this is what a default constructor. As it is object class, it expect only one argument. This function new expect only one argument, which is a string name, and this is what in double quote I have written a class name, this transition class. Okay, now see, if there is any constraint, you can write a constraint within top module. I am creating two objects, or you can say the instances of the class, sequence item 0, sequence item 1, and this is what the class name. Within initial begin, I am just creating these object. This was syntax for that, creating object is equal to class name followed by scope resolution operator, type id, and create within parenthesis double quote, I need to provide this object name. Okay, similarly after that I am randomizing using these object, object dot randomize, and after that I am just printing them. Now see, this is very important. While we are comparing, there are two cases. First one is mismatch case and another one is matching case. Mismatching case is that if we are not doing copy and just we are comparing two transition, then we will get a mismatch case. Now the syntax for compare is very simple. If within parenthesis sequence item 0 dot compare within parenthesis sequence item 1. Okay, so what it means, the sequence item 1 compare with sequence item 0, and I am just displaying the message tick UVM info within parenthesis. I am saying that sequence item 0 is matching with sequence item 1, and this is what the verbosity. Else if not matching, then tick UVM error, sequence item 0 is not matching with sequence item 1, and there is no need to give this verbosity. Okay, and just I am printing with sequence item 0 and sequence item 1. What matching case is, first we need to do a copy. As you know, the syntax for copy, sequence item 1 dot copy within parenthesis sequence item 0, very simple. After that, same method. Okay, now we will try to see the result, what the result we are getting. For that, go to transcript and write our one line code qverilog file name. So this qverilog and file name is all UVM examples. Okay, now see, after this we will get the result and we will try to analyze that result. Now see the result we are getting. We expect this print method to be print for 6 times because we are printing 6 times, right? First, we are printing sequence item 0 and sequence item 1 after randomizing, okay? Now see, this is what the important. First one is mismatching case. Why mismatching case? We are getting result. We are getting error result, right? Sequence item 0 is not matching with sequence item 1. Why? Because now analyze this. Sequence item 0, sequence item 1. Here the address is 14. Here is 11. Write enable is 1 here. Here 0. Okay. Similarly, this write data is 57. Where here is sequence item 1. Write data is 30. Okay. Now see, what is sequence? What is that matching case? Matching case is sequence item 0 is matching with sequence item 1. Why? Because we have first did a copy and after that we are comparing. Okay, now see, analyze the result. Sequence item 1, sequence item 0. Now see, this address is 11 here also. Okay, see here, this is what the matching case. Okay, the address is 14 in sequence item 0, so in sequence item 1 also 14. Now write enable is 0, here also 0, here read enable is 1, here also 1, write data is 57, here also 57, and read data is 0, here also 0. So this is what all about UVM compare method. So first we need to do a copy and then we need to compare. So this was all about UVM compare method. With this, I hope you have understood the concept of inbuilt UVM compare method, and also I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. Thank you.